Hello students, welcome to the e-learning platform presented by Mechanical Engineering Department of Dr. Bapuji Saloke Institute of Engineering and Technology, Kolhapur.
The learning objective for today's session will be number 1, study of types of presses. Different types of presses will be studied in today's session according to their use, according to the power source, according to the type of design, according to the frame. All types of presses will be studied in today's session. Second, study of specifications of press. The different specification on which the press is specified will be studied in today's session. Starting with types of press. Press machine are broadly classified into the following groups. Number 1, according to the power source. According to the power source, we have studied in yesterday's session or in the last session that it is divided into two types, manually operated press, that is hand press or fly press, and second is power presses, that is hydraulic or mechanical presses. These are the classification of according to the power source presses. Next is according to the type and design of frame. According to the type and design of frame. In this, there are number of types of design and frame classified for presses. Some are given below. First is inclinable frame press. Inclinable frame press is mostly used in industry and can be tilted in any position as per the requirement and lock correspondingly. The most commonly used inclinable press is open blade inclinable press as shown in figure. For open back presses, C frame may be fixed in vertical or in a fixed inclined position, or it may be of inclinable type. Its frame is inclined backward, which facilitates the removal of scrap or components through the open back due to gravity. It ranges from 1 ton to 150 ton. The frame of press can be tilted up to 20 degree. Due to such arrangement, the strip feeding and die handling is simplified. Next is the gap frame press. This frame is an integral part of base and cannot be tilted. It is more rigid and stable, hence capable of accommodating large dies. For larger dies, we use this type of gap frame press. Continuing further, according to the type of design, type and design of the frame, the next type is adjustable bed type press. As shown in figure, it carries a knee type bed, hence it is also called as knee press. This knee or bed can be adjustable or adjusted at desired height by moving it up and down with the help of the power screw provided below it. This type of press is used nowadays for small working. Next is straight side frame press. Straight side frame press, this type of frames are preferred in large presses and having larger bed area and high tonnage capacity. Due to straight frame, these types of presses have greater rigidity and enable longer strokes. Next is open end press. In this, the upper side of the press is open. Next is horning press. It consists of vertical frame on which cylindrical post is fitted, which is called as horn. Horn is used for die support and tubular work. So these are the types of frame according to the type and design of frame. Next type of presses can be classified according to the position of frame. The first one is inclinable frame. As we seen the inclinable frame type design of press in earlier part, inclinable frame is one in which the frame is inclined to an angle up to 20 degree and it ranges from 1 ton to 150 ton. Second is vertical frame. Vertical frame is also called as straight side frame and is used for high tonnage capacity. Third, horizontal frame. This type of frame press is used less and for small capacity of work. Next, according to the mechanism used to transmit the power to the ram or according to the ram driven mechanism, the presses can also be classified as according to mechanism used to transmit power to ram or according to ram driven mechanism. First is crank press. It consists of crankshaft driven by a flywheel. The rotary motion of crankshaft is converted into reciprocating motion of ram with the help of connecting rod. Next is cam driven press. Cam driven press is nothing but the with the help of cam operated mechanism we achieve the reciprocating motion of the ram. Third is eccentric press. Eccentric press carries an eccentric drive mechanism for its ram. As the eccentric shaft rotates, the offset between the eccentric center and the center of rotation of shaft provides the required moment. Fourth is hydraulic press. Hydraulic press is the most important type. It provides longer stroke and intensity of pressure can be adjusted as per the requirement. It consists of double acting cylinder and piston. These presses require greater maintenance than the other presses. The last point of types of presses. The presses can be also classified according to the purpose of their use. Some of the operations performed on presses require low stroke length and some require larger stroke length. In the same way, requirements of stroke length is also different for different operation. So presses are also classified according to the purpose of use. They can be classified as seaming press, coining press, forging press, etc. These are all the different types of press, and as per the shearing operation, they can be classified as different types of press. The next point of today's session is specification of press. Expressing size of a machine, that is press, includes expressing each of the parameters pertaining to it quantitatively in appropriate units. Expressing size in above mentioned way is specification of press. The following parameters are expressed as specification of press. The first one is the maximum force. Maximum force that its ram, that a press ram can exert on the workpiece. This is expressed in tons and called tonnage. It varies from 5 to 4000 tons for mechanical press. It may be up to 50,000 tons for hydraulic press. Second is maximum stroke length. Maximum distance traveled by the ram from its topmost position to extreme down position. Maximum stroke length is nothing but the distance traveled by ram from the TDC to BDC. It is expressed in mm. The stroke length is adjustable, so different values that can be obtained between minimum and maximum of stroke length. These are also part of the specification. Third is die space. Die space, total maximum surface area along with the breadth and depth of the bed base, ram base. This is area which die can be maintained. So die space is nothing but the area in which the die can be maintained. Next point in specification of press is the shut height of the press. In a press machine, there is maximum height of the die that can be installed. If this maximum height is exceeded, it is not possible to install the die in the press machine. There are two methods of expressing this height, namely the die height and the shut height, as shown in the figure aside. When the slide is at the bottom dead center position and the slide adjustment screw has been raised to topmost position, the distance from bottom surface of the slide to the surface of bolster plate is called as die height. When the bolster plate is removed from the press machine, the surface on which the bolster plate was is called the head surface, and the shut height is the distance from this head surface to the bottom surface of the slide, that is the distance from the bottom surface to the ram is called as the shut height. And the last is the press size or press capacity in tonnage. Capacity, it is the capacity or rating of an press. There are also other specification such as number of strokes per minute. It is nothing but that it indicates the speed of ram that the press work upon. It is given in RPM. So these are the specification of press. Thank you. This is for today's session. In today's session, we have completed types of presses and specification of press. It is important part from the examination point of view for the specification of press and the types of frame, the types of presses. So study it carefully. Thank you.